There are still a lot of questions surrounding the death of Freddie Gray, specifically exactly what happened inside that police transport vehicle. We decided to take a look at what these vans look like in Connecticut. Also, we wanted to know about the protocol that police use.
We found many differences, including the lack of seatbelts in transport vehicles here. News 8's Bob Wilson gives us a closer look. Bob?
Yeah, you know, we've all seen the photo of him being led in by two officers, being placed inside. We've seen him restrained in handcuffs. We were told he was in leg irons. But what does it look like on the inside, and what could go wrong as they're driving down the road? So this is a similar type of transport vehicle used to transport Freddie Gray. This is one here's in Connecticut. We wanted to show you how it works in Connecticut. First off, we talked with several different police departments, and this is very standard for the type of vehicle used to transport either to or from courts or in a mass arrest. Say like a fight breaks out and you have 5-10 people you can arrest. It's got a divider down the middle. In this case, one side for females, the other side for males, or if you have a couple people who don't get along, you can separate them out. In the Freddie Gray case, there was a prisoner on the other side of this divider who could only hear what was going on, but couldn't see. Now there are several different ways that you can transport a prisoner, either handcuffs in front if you're going to and from court, or you can have them handcuffed in back if they've been arrested, or depending on how aggressive they are, they can either be flex cuffed or handcuffed around the feet and around the wrists, as in the case of Freddie Gray. He was placed in the back, and as you can see, it's a long, hard bench seat, more than 6 feet long. The reason for this, a couple of reasons. One, you can't hide anything in here. You can't stick contraband or anything down in between the seats. Two, a lot of times bodily fluids get sprayed all over back here and they need to hose it out or clean it out so it's easy to clean. Another thing you might notice, no seat belts. Again, we talked with a lot of police departments. It's common not to have seat belts because the seat belt cuts across the body, across the neck. Since you're not facing forward, that belt can do a lot of damage to your neck. Also, police departments are saying there are some safety features built in. In this one, they have a little small glass window that they can look into the back. They can see on either side of the petition. There's also an intercom system overhead so that up front, they can talk to the prisoners in the back and they can listen in to what's going on in the back. In the Freddie Gray case, they say there was only one other person inside the vehicle and they were on the other side of the divider. And something that's interesting about the seat belts, school buses don't have them in a big vehicle like that driving on local city roads. They don't get up very fast. Also, seat belts reaching around and trying to seatbelt somebody in who's very aggressive, very agitated, is a difficult thing to do and places the officer at risk. So they say no seatbelts are necessary in a lot of those transport vehicles. I'm Bob Wilson reporting live in Hartford, News 8.